you come back tomorrow?
Yes.
He landed in the country yesterday morning. I picked him up at the airport at 5 o'clock. Where are you from? I got him to go over.
Yeah.
Yeah, so he was pressed by customs. We're so happy that he's not just gone on a plane and gone right the way back. And he's going to GDC Europe. Please welcome Petri Purho.
Thank you very much for the kind introduction. It's much nicer than the customs at the Australian airport. So, funny thing about this international keynote thing, I was supposed to give this exact same talk about a week ago at Assembly, and instead of working on the lecture, I decided to play a lot of Spelunky. Instead of delivering an interesting talk at Assembly, I decided to play Spelunky in front of a lot of people. And I discussed it as a talk about indie games, but mostly it was just for me to get some time to play Spelunky. Instead of working on this lecture during the last week, I went spelunking again. But my efforts weren't completely wasted because I almost made it to the Golden City. So I thought, because in order for you guys to actually get any kind of a value out of this talk, I'm gonna get the PowerPoint stuff because I actually have a nice new view of this. So I thought, for you guys to actually get some kind of value, I'm gonna give you my game for free, Crayon Physics Deluxe, for everyone who's in the room. I'm going to show you, you have to go to a special website in order to download it. In case you didn't know, Crayon Physics Deluxe won the Independent Games Festival Grand Prize 2008. It was actually pretty cool of them to give it to me. I was up against World of Goo and I felt really disappointed because World of Goo didn't win the Grand Prize and we tend to win. So anyway, you go to this website and you can download it. Just have to type in Crayon's dogs in the search box. But yeah, let's get started with the actual talk. So, I don't know, is there a lot of people here who don't know what Spelunky is? Please raise their hands. Okay, awesome. Now you're actually going to get some value out of this talk. One of the most awesomest games for at least 2009, I think, came out. Beta. This game is made by Derek Yu, and it's a totally awesome indie game that demonstrates what can be done with very simple things, but put into a context. It's a game that has procedurally generated levels, and it's basically really awesome. You can download this game for free. You have to just type in the spelling key in Google search, and it will take you to the download page. The idea in this game is, whoa, that's pretty loud. The idea in this game is to collect as much money as you can and progress down towards the dungeon. And everything that you see is procedurally generated, or the levels are procedurally generated. I'm having some trouble with this too. And the game is extremely punishing, so I've been playing this for like 450 times now. And I've only made it through the game once. Let's try some nasty things. It's gonna be a big rock boulder that comes on. Sweet. Ah! not going well. Oh, sweet. I actually got a pistol. I don't, this is really rare for me to have it. Then you go get to the level and then you get to the next one. So there's a shop here. Or you can play dice in here, but the main thing you want to do in shops is try to steal some stuff. It's pretty close. So anyway, highly recommend going and downloading Spelunky. And maybe we should actually get through the... I made some slides, but I would say that the Spelunky is an important part of the story. So a quick introduction. My name is Petri Purho, and I'm an independent game developer. And I run this one-man studio called Cluedo Games. The title of today's talk is Creativity in Games and in Making Them. And I have a problem with this title because I don't really like the word creativity much, because it's a word that gets used around, it's a word like innovation that gets used around a lot by CEOs and other bastards they're talking about, and they like to use that word a lot. And I've realized that I actually have to distribute you guys some pens and papers. This might take a little while, and I should have probably done it before I started playing Spelunky. Yes. Bunch of pens and papers. And this will probably each take two pieces of paper. Just in case. In the meanwhile, I might play a little bit more Spelunky. So as you can see, the whole point was for me to get as much time to play Spelunky as possible. Because there's going to be some, I'm going to show you actually another game instead of Spelunky, so you actually get some kind of value. This is a game called EnviroBear 2000. I don't know if you know this game, but it's an awesome game about driving. The interesting thing about this game is that they replaced a well-known mechanic for driving with a mechanic that actually doesn't really work that well, which is that you have to control everything you do in this game with a mouse. So, in order to drive in this game, you have to pull down the pedal, and then... the idea is that you have to collect as much food as possible in this game. I have to put it on reverse. And here we go.
Want some more paper?
Oh, sorry?
Okay,
I've got the remix.
I have to try to go to the lake, because I can probably get some fish out of here. And then when you get some fish, you have to eat them like this. This game is actually now available for the iPhone as well, if you want to go support some English. I highly recommend checking it out. It's ridiculously fun.